going to demonstrate how to make a 500 milliliter 0.1 molar sodium hydroxide solution. For this experiment, we're going to only need two chemicals, and that is the sodium hydroxide pellets and the deionized water. For our equipment, because we are making a solution of known molarity, we have to use a volumetric flask. And our volumetric flask has to have written on it the final volume of the solution that we want to make. For today, that will be 500 milliliters. And I already put a label on it so that I don't make any mistakes. It will be a 0.1 molar sodium hydroxide solution. Additionally, we need to weigh out the sodium hydroxide amount. So for that, we're going to need a scale, a weighing boat, a secondary container, and a spatula of some sort. And then because we're making a solution in a volumetric flask, it is very important that we stop adding water when we get very close to the mark. Because when the meniscus of our solution is at the mark, that's when our volume is exactly 500.0 milliliters. When we get very close to it, it is suggested that we move to the use of a pipette so that we don't accidentally exceed the mark. And for my pipette, I will also need a bulb. So let's get started. The first thing that we're going to do is measure out 2 grams of the sodium hydroxide pellets. To do that, first, we open up our container and transfer a small amount of sodium hydroxide pellets into a secondary container. We want to be rather quick with this because sodium hydroxide is a hygroscopic material. Next, we turn on our scale, place our weighing boat on top, tear, and then transfer 2 grams of the sodium hydroxide pellets on it. We need to stop when we are relatively close to the 2 grams. So if it's a little under or a little over, that is acceptable, just not too much. I measured out exactly 2.00 grams of sodium hydroxide pellets. With that, I am done with my scale. I will take my volumetric flask, open it up, take my weighing boat, and transfer the sodium hydroxide pellets into the volumetric flask. With that, I can turn off my scale and set it aside. Next, I'm going to bring in my deionized water. Because there may be traces of the sodium hydroxide on the weighing boat, I will add a small amount of water to it. This will allow any stuck-on residue to dissolve and transfer into the volumetric flask. My weighing boat is completely clean now, and I can set it aside. If it wasn't, I could do another rinse. Next, I can also check on the temperature, and when I have a very small amount of water with the sodium hydroxide, it warms up a little bit. If we add more water, it will cool back down to room temperature. So now we start adding increments of water, and with every addition, we shake our volumetric flask really well. The aim is to dissolve the sodium hydroxide in as little water as possible. If it doesn't work on the first addition, we add more deionized water. And on the first addition, we don't want to add too much water because we want to retain the ability to swirl vigorously. The sodium hydroxide now is fully dissolved and I have a homogeneous solution. For the next portions, we just keep adding the deionized water and swirling until the solution becomes homogeneous. Then we add more. And you'll notice that the closer you are to the neck, the more challenging it becomes to swirl the volumetric flask. And now we are approaching the neck of the flask and approaching the mark on that neck. So at this point, I'm not sure if I can accurately add the right amount of deionized water. So I will switch to a pipette, extract some deionized water from the beaker, and then transfer it into the volumetric flask. Once I get really close to the mark, I will lower myself to eye level and make sure that the meniscus of the solution is exactly at the mark. The meniscus of my solution is exactly at the mark. So now I know that I have exactly 500.0 milliliters of solution. I have the correct amount of solute and I have the right volume as well. So next, I just need to make sure that it becomes homogeneous. And I do that by moving it around and turning it upside down a couple times. If I do it about 3 to 5 times, then I should have a homogeneous solution, which for today is 500 milliliters of 0.1 molar sodium hydroxide.